Do you still know how to start the day?
Yeah.
It's so long ago. They keep asking me, when is your wife appearing again?
Yeah.
When is your beautiful wife appearing again?
Uh-huh.
So let's start the video, guys. Bom dia! Good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to the YouTube channel of the Bitcoin family. Yes, those two that sold their house and literally everything they owned to go all into Bitcoin to start traveling the world. 4 years later now, still traveling the world with our family. Now coming to you guys from Lagos in Portugal. In today's video, of course, talking about the family because we might have found a very beautiful house. Then we will go into some Bitcoin charts, some really cool Bitcoin charts. Yes, I sound bullish because I am bullish about Bitcoin. And then, of course, in the blockchain / news part, talking about Iran because they are really disrupting the world at the moment. And I will tell you my opinion about it. Then we will talk about the Netherlands because somebody just got arrested with $30 million worth of Bitcoin. And we will end the video talking about MicroStrategy because they don't only own Bitcoin, they also run a full node. Enjoy today's video, guys.
Enjoy.
Enjoy today's video, guys. So let's start with the family part, this part, bam! She didn't know that she needed the bam, so she will understand. Now, we're starting with the family part. In the family part, talking about a house. Something, a house, the Bitcoin family and a house. Why the fuck do you want a house? You're digital nomads. You live everywhere in the world where you want. So why do we need a house?
A bungalow.
A bungalow.
It has no stairs.
It has no stairs. It has a stairway to heaven.
Yeah, a rooftop.
Rooftop, yeah. Like terrace.
Okay.
But why do we want a house?
Why do we want a house? Well, we needed a little bit more space for the children, for the girls, because they wanted a bit more privacy from their parents. This is a good house for us because it has four rooms, so everybody has their own room.
Four bedrooms. She's talking about four bedrooms. Yes, we
know.
Sorry,
I didn't pronounce it like that. And sorry.
But my question more was about why would we need a house if we are a digital nomad traveling family? People might not understand it because we always say we don't want to own shit. We don't want to, you know, we want to travel. So
but
why?
But you also always say, but my kids and wife, they would like to stay steady in one place and travel slow. So that's what we're doing now.
Ah, so that's the reason why we need a house, because we are traveling a little bit more slow.
Portugal feels good for us. The weather is good. The surroundings are good. The people are nice. The food is good. So what else do we want more in life than this right now? That's why we chose to stay a little bit longer in Portugal, perhaps 3 months.
We don't know. We don't know. You know, we never planned, but we can rent this house for 3 months. And of course, I will just continue discovering Portugal. I will drive with the car everywhere, and then I will take her, and then I will take one of the kids, and we will sleep in the car, and we will discover whole Bitcoin Portugal for you guys. But from a base, like I said yesterday in my video, from a base in Lagos. Okay, so that was the house part. Then there is another part. You know, guys, you know we have the family token. A lot of you already have family tokens, own family tokens. For this weekend, because it's Halloween, you can buy any t-shirt in our shop for 500 family tokens. So that is not a lot, family tokens, because you got them for free by just watching these videos and scanning these QR codes. And now with these 500 family tokens, you can buy a really cool Bitcoin t-shirt in our store.
You said there are no waves. Look at the waves!
Oh shit, I thought there were no waves because I wanted to swim. But the waves are really high.
Higher than yesterday. It's cool, but wow. I wasn't expecting this.
No, I didn't expect waves as well.
So beautiful the view we have now, and you don't. Now you do.
Now you do have the view. So make sure in this video, again, a QR code, scan the QR code, claim your tokens. And if you have 500 tokens, you can exchange them for a really cool Bitcoin family t-shirt. So before we will walk to the waves, because that sound is really going to disturb because the waves are really high, but I'm going to film the waves later. Now let's go into the Bitcoin part, the part where I bomb you with charts. Let's jump into that Bitcoin part. Bam! And again, she was late. She's not focused.
I was doubting. I wasn't doubting.
Let's take a look at the first chart. On this first chart, created by Willy Hu, you can see that Bitcoin is now slowly decoupling from the stock market, which is really cool. So let's take a look at the chart. 1, 2, 3.
Bam!
Now she was too early. The timing is off today, but...
Your timing is perfect. Mine isn't. You were too late. Yeah, well, I was good.
She didn't have coffee this morning, I think.
No.
You see? But on this chart, guys, you can see that this NVT line is going upwards. You can see the Bitcoin price is going upwards as well, but now you can see that the stock line is decoupling from the Bitcoin price. So we are going down while Bitcoin is going up. This is very positive because this means that a lot of people that normally invest in the stock markets now believe that Bitcoin is a safe haven or this like investment tool where they can increase their capital. So that's really positive when it comes to institutional investors because they now understand, because PayPal onboarded Bitcoin, MicroStrategy onboarded Bitcoin, Grayscale is onboarding Bitcoin. So now all these institutional investors start to believe in Bitcoin as well. And that is why they are slowly starting to hedge their funds, their capitals into Bitcoin instead of stocks or any other asset because they want to survive the next economical crash. Cool chart by Willy Hu. Thanks Willy for doing all these cool charts. Do you still remember Willy?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he was with us in Thailand.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice guy.
At the
House of Dao. Yeah, at that point it was still called... Yeah, it was called House of Dao at that point. Mm-hmm. Utopia. It was an utopia, yeah. And that we met Willy and Tone Vase and all these guys. And we had a lot of fun. And normally, guys, I would come with another very bullish chart. Maybe we turn around and we walk there. And then we go to sit on the beach somewhere. Or do you want to go to the beach club tent?
Yeah, I like a coffee.
Okay, then we continue. So normally, guys, I would come with another bullish chart. But this time, I will start with a bearish chart. This one. 1, 2, 3.
Bam!
Oh, she sounds so sexy when she says bam. I see, when I see this, I say bam.
Move on.
We are moving on. No. I don't know if you noticed, but we are moving.
Not physically, but mentally.
I think it will never grow old mentally. I think it will always be a kid. I don't know why.
That's not being a kid, that's being... In Holland you call it oversexed.
Oversexed. I think in English it's the same word, oversexed.
Yeah.
If not, comment below. How do you say it when somebody thinks about sex a lot? Is it called oversexed or is it like just a normal guy? Let us know in the comment below. And while doing so, give the video a thumbs up because she's always talking about sex. Do you notice, by the way, every video I make single, without kids, just me, I never talk about sex. And then when she joins the game, what subject do we talk about? Sex. Sex in the dunes, sex in the mountains, always sex with her. So it's not me. It is oversexed.
Yeah. Blame it on the other guy.
But let's bam the chart back into the screen again because we already like, I zoom always out when we talk too much. So we need to say bam another time. 1, 2, 3.
Bam!
On this chart, guys, you can see 3 waves. Wave 1, wave 2, no, 2. Wave 2 and wave 3. When you look at these waves, you can see they make a climb. The first wave goes up and then comes down. And then the point where the first wave comes down, the second wave starts. And then the second wave goes up and then it crashes down. And then it crashes down to the top of the first wave. So take a look. So you see the second wave going up and then it crashes down to the top of this first wave. Now we saw the third wave. The third wave went all the way up to $14,000. If we would crash down to the top of the second wave now, we would fall back to $12,000 per Bitcoin, which I told you yesterday as well, that could be possible. Because if we create a double top, so we try to break $14,000 twice, then we can get a correction downwards all the way to 12K. I think the number exactly is 12,153, somewhere in that region. We could see a pullback to there, so put some buy orders around 12,150 78, because that's my birth year. So, and then probably when Bitcoin dips, you buy Bitcoin a little bit cheap before it goes again to try and break 14K, and then you make 2K profit in a very simple way while you're sleeping or walking the beach or having sex with your wife.
Nah, that wasn't me at all.
No, no, it was me.
Sorry, beep.
But to be very honest, guys, you know what I always say. What do I always say? You need to
zoom.
She's getting tired of this, but you need to
zoom. No.
You need to.
But you do it way much better than I do.
Okay, so you always need to, guys, zoom out on the charts. So yes, you can start to freak out now of these 2K dips here and there. But if you zoom out on the charts, please take a look at yesterday's video. I will put a link down upstairs here, this eye. If you see the eye, if you click that, you can see yesterday's video. And the eye will be in the screen, I think, till the end of the video. So also at the end of the video, you click that eye. And then you can watch yesterday's video so you don't freak out of this small movement, because then you understand the big movement in Bitcoin. And then you will understand that you will only go higher the next 12 to 16 months. And then we have another really cool thing. That is, tomorrow, the 31st of
October
is Bitcoin's white paper birthday. That means the white paper was published on the 31st of October. That was not when the first transaction happened to Bitcoin. That is somewhere in January, but the first white paper was published on the 31st of October. So there's always this battle. When is Bitcoin's birthday? Is it on the day that the white paper was published, or is it on the day that the first transaction in Bitcoin appeared? I choose to celebrate both of them. So tomorrow I will probably hook up with some Bitcoin people here in town and have a drink. She doesn't know yet, I just told her, and I think she will join me for a drink. We need to celebrate Bitcoin's white paper birthday, and then in January we do it again, and then we celebrate the birthday of the first Bitcoin transaction. So don't fight about it, just celebrate life and celebrate all the events that are in Bitcoin.
Yes. Take every
opportunity
you can. Yes. To celebrate.
You do. Yeah,
my hand is sleeping.
Yes, my left hand was sleeping. That's why I use this hand. And I know there is somebody going to put a comment now. You're blocking your wife, and your hand is in between of you. Sorry, my other hand is like tired. It's like, it's down now. Okay, sorry guys. The video is again becoming a little bit too long. So let's jump into blockchain/news part, this part.
Bam!
Timing perfect. Did you read the news yesterday, guys, about Iran? Iran just announced on state level that they are going to allow and see Bitcoin as an official value to use for import goods into Iran. So now everybody, all the companies, all the private persons in Iran can legally start to import goods into Iran by using Bitcoin. This might sound like normal to you guys, but this is huge, because Iran was fully depending on the US dollar. And because of all the US sanctions to Iran, Iran didn't have dollars anymore, so they couldn't import anymore. Can you imagine how a country feels when they cannot import anymore because they are forced into a corner by another huge country like the United States? I don't know, I've never lived in such a country, but I think it feels like terrible. And now the Iran government said, fuck it, we are going to use Bitcoin to do import. So we are going to do all the international trades with Bitcoin. Import, export, and everything is just legal from now. And you know Iran already started to mine Bitcoins with huge power plants like 8 months ago. So this was all pre-planned, in my opinion. I think they started to mine a shitload of Bitcoins by allowing power plants to use the energy to mine Bitcoins. And now they are going to use these Bitcoins to import goods into Iran. Really smart move, but also a very dangerous move, because I do think that could be a reason for example, the US to invade Iran again and to start a war, because, you know, they just want these countries to be dependent on the United States, on the Western countries, on the Western world. And sorry guys if I offend you because you're like living in the US, because like 19% of our viewers is from the United States. I don't want to offend you, but you know, this is just how it is. This is just how economy has been done the last couple of decades. And I think it's going to be a huge shift now because of these beautiful tools, blockchain and Bitcoin. And now Iran is the first country to give an example, but I think many countries will start to use Bitcoin and other DeFi decentralized cryptos, for example, the central bank's decentralized cryptos, to do import and export, and by that surpass the US dollar, the Chinese yuan, and all these other high-level currencies. So let's see how this will evolve, but it can go two ways. It can go the really bad way, and then we get a war, and then can go the really good way, and then we get open economy all over the world because of blockchain and Bitcoin. Let me know what you think about it, so leave a comment down below, because I love it if you educate me on this. Maybe I am completely wrong. Maybe you have another opinion. So let me know your opinion down below in the comments, so you can educate me while I educate you. Thanks for that already in advance. I was searching for the word. That's why the sentence was in advance. And then there is another really cool news. I find it cool, because the Dutch police just arrested a couple in the Netherlands, in Hilversum, because they laundered money. Yeah, they laundered money, and they had like for 30 million US dollar in bitcoins. So they had like about 2,500 bitcoins, and they were arrested now because they have been laundering money for multiple years. So gone bitcoins. Let's see if the police or the tax company in the Netherlands is going to sell those bitcoins now, because they just confiscated the bitcoins. So what are they going to do with it?
Give them to us. No, and we give them to charity.
That would be nice.
But wasn't there another, not couple, but two guys who got arrested as well for money laundering in Holland, in Rotterdam, I believe?
I think it's the same.
Oh, they are the same, okay.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a man and a wife, or a couple and a boy,
I don't know.
Or a girl and a girl.
No, I thought maybe again somebody.
But it was in the news today here in the Decrypt platform. I always, because I like the Decrypt platform, that was the one that featured us as well like a week ago where we were. So they just made this news item today, so that's why I'm saying it today. Maybe it already happened yesterday or the day before.
No, a week ago,
shit,
I believe.
Shit, now.
I told you about tell something, doesn't come in.
Do you see how it works?
If he reads or hears it from somebody else, that's what marriage about. They don't ever listen.
And I thought I had a scoop now for you guys, and now she's ruining my scoop. She's like, it was a week ago, dude. Okay, wake up, Didi. It was a week ago, probably, or it's another couple. We don't know for sure. But
I'm gonna Google it.
They were arrested because they money laundered, and they had $30 million worth of Bitcoin, 2,500 Bitcoins gone. And I want to know now, the Dutch government, the police, and all that people that confiscated those Bitcoins, what are you going to do with the Bitcoins? Are you again going to buy a speedboat for our king in the Netherlands? Or are
don't
you?
Go down.
Why not? Maybe then Joep van de Hek will look our video and he will agree with me, because our king is buying speedboats while everybody
our king
in the
is
Netherlands.
A little bit.
Yeah, he's buying speedboats while everybody in the Netherlands is going bankrupt. So that's why. I don't know. Other discussion. We don't want a kingdom anymore. I don't believe in a kingdom anymore. But that's another discussion. Other video. Let's stop it, Didi, because else you'll be arrested in Portugal because you just insulted the king of buying a bit.
No, it's your opinion, and we are free to say our own opinion.
Yeah, we have a
Wilders
also, yeah. Many people, that's one of the advantages of the Netherlands. You are free to express your thoughts.
Express yourself.
Do we need to make a move? Like, not a Madonna move. And then the last news, guys, because I want to keep it short, because else I will go too negative about the Netherlands, and I don't want that, because I love the color of orange, because it's also the color of Bitcoin. But MicroStrategy, you know, they own like about 30,000 Bitcoins with the company. But the cool thing now is that they don't only buy it, you know, to make money, because then they would only buy and hodl, but they also now run a full node, which means they are tremendously supporting the whole Bitcoin industry, because, you know, running a full node says I care for this industry. And of course, with running a full node, you can make some money as well, but you support the network. That is how the network of Bitcoin is being decentralized. The more people run full nodes, the more decentralized the whole Bitcoin blockchain industry will be. And that is exactly what we need. If you run a full node at your home, you are contributing to the decentralization of the Bitcoin blockchain. And that is very important, to keep the power decentralized and not centralized by a few huge miners that have all the control on all the Bitcoin nodes. That was everything for today. I hope you really enjoyed the video today. If you did enjoy the video, what do they need to do?
Oh god, no, I'm not up to that. No, something like thumbs up and click below and hit the bell, but I don't know. Okay. I'm terrible at this.
So if you like the video, give the video a thumbs up.
That one I did good.
That was good. Share with your friends and family.
Yeah.
Subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell. That one. Please leave a comment because I love to reply to the comment. Yes, I just touched her boobs. But it's my wife. Thanks for watching.
Thanks
and hopefully
for watching.
See you tomorrow again. And
next time.
No, you wanted to say something very good. And always remember to zoom out in crypto
and
to
zoom
in at life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, as that is exactly what life is about. And exactly what we are now going to do. I am going to take a coffee, a dive in the sea, a cocktail, and sleep on the beach. Wait, oh, I'm still wearing my flip-flops. That's why the energy was, you know, I need to be grounded. She taught me. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.
Bye.